Hello and welcome, I'm Carl the Landscape Guy. Today I would like to give you an insight on the roof greening of an underground parking garage. Before we start with the roof construction, here are a few photos from the preparation. This underground parking garage extends under these two new buildings and connects them to each other. On top of the underground garage, an inner courtyard will later be built between the buildings. We start on the backside, where we have to take down the board pile wall. In order for this to be possible, the slope must first be braced with precast concrete retaining panels. You will find a detailed video about this on my channel. The slope area can only be reached via the roof of the underground garage. The roofer has already glued on the first three sheets of waterproofing so that we can start with the angular retaining panels. Here is our material for the new retaining wall. We protect the waterproofing with protection mats and then start to mortar, apply, and compact the filling material. The first row of angular panels can then be placed on top of it. The pieces are set with an excavator, and sometimes the excavator driver puts into effect his special skills to set them right. Behind the wall, there's a drainage package consisting of a drain pipe, gravel, and fleece fabric around it. Then it can be backfilled and compacted. Then a secondary retaining wall is added because the slope is relatively steep. Between the two walls, greenery will be planted later. While the roofers work hard to seal the entire underground parking garage with root-resistant waterproofing membrane, we can start dismantling the board pile wall. This was delayed due to bad weather, but without a roof membrane, no green roof. And with the roofing finally finished, we can start with the layering construction of the green roof. First of all, a white protective fleece fabric is applied to the clean membrane. This is very important to prevent damage to the waterproofing. The fleece is 500 grams per square meter and will also continue up the sides. For this construction, a so-called slip layer of PE sheet is placed next. Over time, horizontal forces can occur and the slip layer is supposed to absorb these tensions. Because of the sheet, the entire roof structure can slide on the fleece if necessary. We now place the FKD drainage and water storage elements from Optigreen. Here we have to lay two different FKD elements, which at first glance look exactly the same. They are available with holes at the top and holes at the bottom. The elements with drilled holes at the top are laid in the area of subsequent greening. The holes at the top ensure an accumulation of water of approximately 23 liters per square meter. In the area where it will later be paved, the FKDs with drilled holes at the bottom must be laid, so that quick and good drainage can take place. Large elements can be laid relatively quickly. The drain water later runs under the FKD elements to this drain, which leads the water down through the underground garage into the sewer. When all elements are laid and cut to size, they are filled with a lava draining material. This drainage fill is light, resilient, and drains water well. It is delivered with this truck and blown onto the surface through a hose. It can therefore be applied quickly and easily without driving over the FKD elements with a wheel loader. This material is the bulk material Pearl 8 to 16 millimeters from Optigreen, and it ensures a pressure-stable filling of the FKD elements. This material is used for both extensive and intensive greening. compartments of the elements must be filled up to the top. A special and expensive building material is used for the next construction layer. This is foam glass gravel. The foam glass is delivered loose and brought onto the roof with the small Scheffer wheel loader. This material is used here to keep the weight down. Otherwise, the total structure of about 50 centimeters in thickness would have too high of a load on the underground garage ceiling. We use the material OptiPour 10 to 75 millimeters. It is about 20 centimeters thick, and this glass foam layer is covered with a separation layer, a thin fleece. Now, in the area of the paved surfaces, mineral gravel 0 to 32 millimeter is laid out, leveled and compacted. Simultaneously, we're still working to continue on the dismantling of the board pile wall. Here you can clearly see where the walkway will be later. A light substrate is being used in the remaining areas. This draining vegetation substrate ensures good water drainage and a sufficient supply of nutrients to the plants. Now we can already start with the paving work. The main entrances to the residential buildings are accessible from the roof of the underground car garage. In addition, these lawn grid slabs will also be used. They are made of plastic and save you some weight compared to concrete lawn grids. The mineral gravel is covered with a 3 cm bedding of material sand 2 to 8 mm. The lawn grid is laid in order to provide a stable surface for fire trucks. The pathways are finished and the grid plates have been filled with substrate. Now there are still some fixtures to be installed, like gratings in front of the entrances and bicycle stands. And so the roof construction is finished. But what would be a green roof without greenery? The architect has planned a lawn with beech hedge elements. It is not quite green yet due to the cold weather, but the construction site is now finished. Many thanks to the company Optigreen and Raiffeisen for their collaboration. And a final thank you to Balzer Landscaping Construction Company and their employees' excellent work. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check my channel for more construction site videos about garden and landscaping. Thank you very much for watching, and I see you next time. I'm Carl the Landscape Guy.